There we go, Louise Bennett coming out. She's 3-0, undefeated, representing Kingdom MMA and fighting for the British title. Louise Bennett taking on Katalin Aranyi. I mean, what you try to do as commentators is present an unbiased opinion. But, I mean, Louise Bennett has got to be a huge favourite going into this fight. But, that doesn't mean she's going to win. Because Katalin Aranyi was a huge underdog in her last fight. And she got caught with a few big shots. And then she was smart enough, transitioned well enough, to catch a beautiful submission and tap out her previous opponent, Jasmine Harmon. And she's the comeback kid. And she's got Lucas Lepienka in her corner. An absolutely fantastic jiu-jitsu coach over there at Blood, Sweat and Tears. And he will be giving her all the advice. But she is going to have her hands full with the very talented 3-0 Louise Bennett. Louise had a win by decision, a win by KO, and a win by rear naked choke. Here we go. We have Katalin taking on Louise Bennett for the British 59 kilogram title. Here we go. Oh, Katalin running across, super aggressive. Bennett, time in the takedown. I thought we would see this from Bennett. She's so polished, her grappling is so good. I was just staying casted. Louise Bennett coming in 3-0, possibly a big favorite in this fight. But Katalin, we've seen before, she is the comeback kid. And she's dangerous. You saw that by running across the stage. Who does that?
She is very, very dangerous. And the look she had on her face before the fight started, I was terrified myself emceeing this.
The intensity in the cage.
So intense.
Yeah. And Louise Bennett is experiencing something that happens in MMA fights. The gloves are too big. We got a little bit more padding.
Yep.
Which keeps you safe. But Katalin is just pinching her legs together and actually trapping the arm of Bennett. And all those beautiful jiu-jitsu transitions and drills that she's practiced in the gym, she can't do any of them because her right hand is stuck. But yeah, at some point, Katalin's going to have to try and move her legs because she's also stucking herself to the floor, essentially. So she's going to have to release it at some point. And then it'll be Louise Bennett looking for the transitions, trying to get to a dominant spot. Nearly slipping her out. Nice. Going knee on belly. That's what I like to do if the glove gets stuck. Or knee on head if you're feeling really mean. Oh, beautiful transition to the back.
Yeah, great transition. One hook in already. She's going to try and work the ground and pound. Get that second hook in, which she has now. Try and flatten Katalin out. Working really, really well. She'll keep working this ground and pound until she finds an opening to get that under the chin.
And that's right in front of our table here, Carsten. You can hear those shots thudding against the head of Katalin.
I know, thunderous ground and pound there from...
But she has lost the hooks now. Katalin doing a good job of escaping. And Louise Bennett getting the hooks back in. Both hooks back in. Lucas Lepienka in the corner of Katalin Aranyi. He's an incredibly decorated Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu coach over there at Blood, Sweat and Tears. And a BJJ black belt. But is this the case that Katalin's a little bit outclassed in this fight? She's struggling at the moment.
Yeah, this is definitely the game plan for Louise coming into this, is take the girl down, beat her up on the floor and try and get this submission.
And at the moment it's working, but this is what we've seen from Katalin before. You know, not always the smoothest technique, but she's so tough, so durable, and she's got so much heart. And you give her half an opportunity and she will dive on it. But at the moment it's still all Louise Bennett. And she's mixing well between going for the chokes and then still doing some damage just like that, landing some big shots.
Huge shots here in the corner.
Oh, nearly slipped off the side, didn't Louise Bennett. Finished on the back. It's very, very strong round for Louise Bennett. Would you give that a 10-8, Carsten? Because, I mean, a couple of big shots. It was very one-sided.
I mean, yeah. So, again, we're coming back to this point scoring again. If you think about it, Catalina had one attempt to throw a punch. The second one she threw, Louise slipped out of the way and then did the double leg. And then from there onwards, it was all Louise. So you're looking over a 3-minute round, 2.5 minutes, Louise was on top, dominating the position, landing a good ground and pound, submission attempt. So it has to be a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think sometimes 10-8 is only scored when you see something spectacular. You know, you see someone wobble, or the choke looked like it was death, but then they slip out. But like you said, it's such a dominant round. That's why it's a 10-8 round. It was complete dominance by Louise Bennett. But we saw this in Katalin and Aranyi's last fight. She was dominated for a couple of rounds, but weathered the storm and then came back and caught her opponent in a submission. And I wouldn't be surprised she runs across and tries to punch her again. Oh, front kick up the middle.
Yeah, Louise showing some good head movement here, just gliding out of the way of these shots.
Nice right hand as well. I mean, if it was a mean mugging competition, Katalin would be winning.
Oh my God, she beat every male, female in here.
Oh, nice kick. Came through under the elbow. Oh, lovely shots. Beautiful. I mean, Louise is doing such a good job of feinting and moving. Slipping shots. Getting back to the middle of the cage. Staying safe. She's not underestimating her opponent. Not overcommitting to anything. Nice left hook, straight right. Timed the takedown perfectly. But ended up on the bottom. Ooh, that was dangerous there for Louise. Managed to scramble on top.
Yeah, good recovery by Louise there. She did sort of overcommit with the takedown and end up rolling through. But now she's back in the top position. She's trying to pass to that side control. She's got good head position here.
Yeah, some just beautiful fundamental jiu-jitsu going on there. Oh, Katalin catches half. Louise spinning to the back. She's trapped her arm as Katalin. She's quite hard to read as Katalin. She doesn't always react the way you're expecting. Turns in. Oh, nearly ends up on top, but Louise read it. Gave it to the back position, took the mount. Carsten, what does Katalin have to do to get out of this position?
So again, she needs to scoot herself up, get Louise's weight on her hips and then bridge from there. Or possibly try and trap the leg and go into the half guard. Just get away from that mounted area.
Yeah, and especially with a minute to go, you have to be super active. You have to be looking like you're trying to escape. We saw those big shots from Louise earlier. You can't eat too many of those in the bottom. Louise looking for a head and arm choke.
Yeah, she's trying to set that up now. She's got the position with the arm. And she's turning now, possibly for an arm bar.
Oh, Katalin's very slick then. Saw that coming. Used the opportunity to get back to her knees. I think Louise only got one hook. She's going to look for the second hook. Oh, got that easily. Oh, lost it again. Pulling the head. It's interesting, Katalin's grappling style, because something she does from a straight Brazilian jiu-jitsu perspective, I would just say are wrong, but she makes it work. Is she under the chin, or does it matter? Can she just crank the face? Oh, loses it. 10 seconds. This British title fight, 2 10-8 rounds possibly. but Katalin is not out of this. She's still dangerous. Yeah, it's sometimes you roll with someone, jiu-jitsu wrestling, with someone who's done a different martial art, or they have a very different approach to it. You're expecting a certain reaction, and then when they don't do that, it kind of catches you off guard, because they kind of don't. It's a bit like boxing. Maybe you box someone that's never boxed.
Yeah.
And like all of a sudden they're switching stance and they're moving in a way that you wouldn't expect. And it can slightly catch you off guard. You
know? Yeah, definitely.
In some ways, it's easier to box someone that's trained 6 months than not at all, because they've become fairly predictable in what they're going to do. Of course, you've got to get through that stage to then be dangerous.
Yeah, definitely. But no, it is true. It's obviously, you know, you all learn the same kind of basics to start with. So when you sort of go against somebody that's been doing it for a little while, you kind of expect what they're going to do, where they're going to move. But for somebody like Catalina, who is has had such a unique style for herself, you kind of never know what's going to happen.
Yeah. And it's effective as well. I mean, she's in here fighting for a title. Two rounds down, but still dangerous, still coming forward. Well, accepted that takedown just a bit too easily. She's trying to hang on the neck.
Yeah, corner shouting for her to stand up now. They want her to try and, you know, keep, get this standing and sort of finish the round, trying to find the finish on the feet.
She's what is she trying to do with her arm? She's got kind of weird wizard trap on her arm, just holding onto it, I think. Let's forget being unorthodox, being hard to read, being difficult. But Louise Bennett has been very dominant in this fight so far. Once again, switching to the knee on belly, she showed fantastic.
She's got that arm trapped between the legs again, like in the first round. So she's going to go on knee on belly, trying to get that loose. Hopefully, land some ground and pound and see if she can get finished herself now.
It's one of those weird ones, isn't it, Carsten? There's like certain positions, like holding a guillotine when someone's got side control. You're kind of keeping yourself safer, but also limiting your own options. Katalin's limiting her own ability to escape by trapping the arm. So it's just a survival technique more than a winning technique.
So Louise is free now. Let's see what she can do now. She's got both arms back.
The durability of Katalin is very impressive, but it's only impressive because essentially this fight is very one-sided. Louise Bennett.
It's very one-sided, but she is making it very difficult for Louise.
Yeah.
Making it very frustrating. And that's what she does. She makes it really frustrating and then tries to get a finish towards the end, but
yeah.
I don't think she's going to get it this time.
Yeah, it's interesting there, Mr. Referee Paul Nichols. You can't grip the cage with your hand, but you know, some people try and grip it with their feet. And it's a hard one not to do if you have a bridge off a cage or push it with your foot. But Katalin trying to sneak out the back, almost deep half maybe. But Louise Bennett sees it.
Yeah, she's just using them hips nice and heavy, trying to push it down, trying to land some ground and pound. She's doing everything she can to get the finish herself, but it's just Katalin's style of just being really frustrating is wearing on her a little bit.
Oh, knees, thunderous knees. But this is great for Louise Bennett. She's getting experience, getting cage time. Lots of different looks, transitions, checking that cardio. Oh, trapping the arm. She's looking for Americano with a few seconds
crucifix
left.
Crucifix and then a couple of seconds left now. She can land a few more shots. There she goes. Finishing strong.
Yeah, wow. That was our title fight.
I think we can safely say that Louise Bennett will now be the new champion.
Even Marty Wolf could judge that one. We're going to have a look at Marty, see which way he scored it. Just see what he thinks. Marty, I am teasing. Of course, Marty is our head judge here at Battle Arena and expert at what he's doing. Also a friend of mine, so I've got to tease him a little bit. I'm going to ask him which way he scored it. I think a blind and deaf mute could have scored that fight. Great toughness by Katalin not to get finished. But the night definitely belongs to Louise Bennett. Constant skills. Consummate professional. Thank you.